Now, are you 60-40 or 50-50 or what? What's the deal?
I would say more recently, just because, I mean, I've been dating, you know, a man. It's been over a year and just fucking him. So now, like, 65-35 as far as, like, maybe hetero. But throughout my lifetime, I believe 50-50. And I only say that because there's a thing called this Kinsley scale. I don't know if you've ever heard of it.
No,
and sure.
If you take a look at it, it's, you have?
Dr. So
it
has Kinsley, a man,
yeah, on a scale. And it basically says you're either a 1, completely hetero, or like a 10, completely homosexual. And like there's some people that are in the middle. Mm-hmm. And there are days where maybe I'm more one than the other. But for the most part, when I'm looking at people out, I think it's the same. That's the only reason I think it's 50-50. Mm. When I'm out and I look at a woman or a man, if they're both on the train, I'm both attracted to them, my mind goes both ways. I don't really prioritize one over the other. But from a romantic perspective, when I'm with men, there's one thing that's different. I want to fuck girls.
Oh, you want to fuck girls?
And when I'm, no, I'm saying like, I just want to fuck them. But when I'm with women romantically, sometimes I miss men emotionally.
Really? So you're more 65-30 or 70-30 guy? So you still like the comfort of that?
I think that this, maybe this, the masculinity of men that make me feel that way. Because when I date women, I date the girliest girls because I already like niggas. So what's the point in getting a butch chick when I can just, you know? And that's no shade to butch women. I just like women all the way.
That's like me in fast cars. Like, I don't believe in fast cars. I rode bikes all the time, and I've done 196 on a bike at a time. And once you do that, it's like what you're saying. It's like, why would I get in a car? Like, it's nothing compares.
You are the analogy king, but yes.
Yeah. Why would you do that?
Where the fuck is this heat? Where the fuck are you going with this shit?
She does that all the time, and then she's like, oh, okay, I got it. Okay.
I didn't get it.
Weezy, you never miss the, you said you miss the emotionality or the emotional connection with men, but not the emotional connection with women when you're with a man. Is that my understanding?
Correct. And that's what
you like the dude. You like the dude and when you're with a girl. Like, you're the aggressive.
A little bit, but I will say, I think that that happens to me, Harry and Dante, because when I am in a relationship, I do very well in relationships. I eat better. I'm healthier. Like, I'm not getting fucked up. I'm not trying to go party or do or whatever it might be. It makes me very stable. And stability sometimes comes for me, or me feeling okay or emotionally safe comes from a dominant person.
Right.
And it may be like a motherly figure, a fatherly figure, a teacher type of thing. I don't know what it is, but generally I do look at men in that way.
Right, right.
And women just can't give it to me. I feel like I've tried to have it, but it's very hard. I don't know why. My ex-girlfriend, she was amazing. I have no issue with her, but I think that that was something that was hard for her.
Right, to give you that kind of rock to lean, that somebody like, to lean on.
You're fine as fuck. You're not about to, what are we going to do when somebody busts through the door? Like, I can't, it's weird.
It's interesting because you just said that you don't go for a tough girl. So in a way, you're looking for the comfort of being taken care of to whatever degree that means by a man. But you don't have that with a woman because you're not going for that at all. So it's kind of a double-edged sword, or you're kind of doing it to yourself in a way. Not that I'm blaming you.
But I think that what the issue is, like, you know, there's a lot of different types of people, so to speak. We can say, as far as like your sexual orientation, you can be a pansexual person, which means that you don't have a choice between men or women, right? You just, it's people. And I think that when I start dating women, that happens. And then long term, I realize that the larger issue is that masculinity factor, right? But maybe I just need to get with a girl who's strap up, and I'll be all right.
Yeah, but you also find that, like, and I've like, we've interviewed a couple of SN, you know, like dominatrix and stuff, and even dominatrix is like, they still want that masculine element. Like, they'll go strap on and fuck a dude, but they won't date a dude that they fuck. Or it's almost like this emasculation of it. Am I?
I think that that comes into what's your kink or your fetish, and yeah. what's something that you want every day when it comes to that, right? I think that there's a lot of duality in people.
Right, right.
Which is what happens with me with women and men, right? But for the dominatrix thing that you're talking about, I just know that with sex work, mm-hmm. a lot of people do things that they may not have done
right.
in their everyday life. And I think that's why it's that way. My co-host particularly talks about pegging a lot and how she enjoys it. Mm-hmm. Her current partner doesn't want to be pegged, but she's always said, like, I'd be able to do the let me peg him, because she's taken out the thing of getting right. fucked in the ass is emasculating.
Right,
like
right.
That, I think it's all how we look at it. With doms in particular, I think that the reason that happens is because it's a way to separate their work and their real life. So it's okay. like, this is just something I'm going to do, and even if this is not the type of person I'll be with. But I don't know. I would say, at least as far as sex, I'm submissive with everybody, men or women.
Right, right.
But I'm a lazy bitch.
You think that's where it comes from? You're like,
I'm low effort.
I just yeah. want
I'd be like, get on top.
You know what? I say this all the time, and women who like wear the strap on and whatever, you don't know, understand. It takes a lot of core strength. A lot of core yeah. strength, a lot of
and
endurance.
It's heavy, a strap on. A lot of people don't think about the weight. It's not just core strength,
the distribution.
So, like, you can't just
yo,
get
son,
the slimy
I think about strap. That weight all the time. You know what I mean?
We like heavy dicks, and we want a heavy strap. And, yeah. like, oh, my God, sometimes, like, if you don't have the right thing, it's very expensive. I had to hold it because, like, the harness wasn't straight. It's a lot of work. I actually prefer to scissor. I don't like strapping up because I think it's just too much work.
With sex toys in general, you get what you pay for. You splurge a little, live a little.
You do. I've got one right next to me in this house.
That's our resident dirtbag.
That's our resident.
Andre's our resident. I mean, Harry's our resident dirtbag.
What are you talking about? Just on occasion, you know, I like to take things up a notch. That's all.
Hey, listen. Hey, I'm not judging. Hey. I'm not judging. I'm just stating a fact.
You know, what's wrong with some light choking, as our last guest Amanda once said?
Little
you know?
Tie wraps. What's wrong with tie wraps? Huh?
Fair enough.
Young Man School 202. Better hear what I've got to say, because you won't get it again.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man.
Better man.
Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.